The Isle of Skye is a legendary location for landscape photographers. Located in western Scotland, the island is rich on epic and diverse landscapes and iconic locations. We spent 3 days on the island in the middle of September and was lucky to have all sorts of weather.
This is just absolutely glorious. That was crazy, but so worth it. So I've come out here, deep into the Scottish Highlands, to this old, authentic bridge. It's so beautiful, and it's the heart of Scotland itself. And obviously, it's a huge tourist magnet, as with everything else up here in the Isle of Skye. But anyway, the bridge is still very pretty.
The Sligachan Bridge is located next to the main road at Loch Sligachan and is probably one of the first major tourist hotspots in the Isle of Skye you will pass. And that's a thing to note about Isle of Skye. It's a tourist magnet. If you want not too expensive accommodation in the Isle of Skye, you'll have to book months in advance or go camping. If you can ignore all the tourists, the Isle of Skye is a candy shop for landscape photography. There are plenty of spots to photograph from around the bridge. If you have somewhat clear weather, you will have a good amount of backdrops to choose from to really immerse the bridge in the surrounding Scottish landscape. Problem being with clear weather though is the amount of water running underneath the bridge might be fairly limited, making the scene kinda boring. We had 3 days in the Isle of Skye with many different weather situations, which luckily was a huge benefit. We could choose where to go on the isle based on the weather and optimize our photos. You would probably benefit the most from a 16-35mm lens at this location. Not far from the bridge you'll find the Sligachan waterfalls, which are also worth a visit, but I prioritized other locations on this visit. On the westernmost tip of the Isle of Skye, you'll find the Neist Point Lighthouse. It's a super famous site for Instagrammers and landscape photographers alike. It's easy to find using your GPS, but the road out there is quite long and narrow, so be careful in the traffic. On an evening with a promising sunset, literally every photographer on the isle knows where to gather, so the parking lot fills up fast. There are quite a lot of different vantage points and compositions to get in this area. It's just about exploring. The most famous vantage point is on top of the ridge, but because of the huge amount of photographers, I decided to go to another location.
Whoopsie! All right, Neist Point Lighthouse. It feels a bit redundant to make a video from here because it's so famous, and as you've already seen, there's so many photographers here. We have actually abandoned the typical place of taking a picture, even though that's kind of what I wanted. And gone a bit down the stairs and a bit further down, and then actually a bit up again. So you can see here in the background, up here on top is where there's a huge line of photographers. But they didn't want us in front, and I had to go pretty far in front to have the horizon line broken by the tip here. If you don't break the horizon line, you will just have one horizontal line straight through your picture, and it doesn't always look so aesthetic. So we have come to this location instead, and it's just so much better.
On top of the horizon not being broken from the normal vantage point, you will have it almost line up with the top of the cliff, which to me creates a lot of visual tension. It's like two parts of the photo battling for and drawing attention. As in portrait photography, you don't want the top of your subject's head to line up with the horizon. You want to draw the viewer's eyes to your focal point, which in this case is the lighthouse, and not to some visual disturbing parts of your scene. It was a fairly easy photo to compose. The foreground required a bit of management, but it's not too important for this composition, so you can easily leave out the nearest foreground. You'll be fine with a standard 24-70mm lens here. We had huge problems with midges, making this the worst photography experience we had in all of Great Britain. We'd forgotten our spray and hadn't invested in mosquito nets. Do not do that mistake. The fairy pools are located in the southern part of the Isle of Skye and is easily found via Google Maps. It's another typical tourist hotspot where there are not enough space for all the cars and no toilet facilities. When you've found yourself a spot for parking, there's a small hike down to the pools. The pools are small ponds of water along a gorge created by the stream of water from the mountains. As I mentioned in the last episode, the amount of water running off the mountains depends hugely on the amount of rain and melting snow. After a couple of dry days, we luckily got some rain which filled the streams. From the bottom and all along up the stream, there's an endless amount of fantastic compositions, which all vary dependent on the amount of water. Some days some compositions make sense, while other days they won't. We followed the stream all the way beyond the ferry pools as to scout out different spots of interest and work our way back down. Just beyond the pools, we found a superb composition.
So I found this beautiful, beautiful composition with a very, very strong leading line, or strong leading lines leading into this waterfall up here above and up onto the mountain. I'm sorry for looking like a complete dork, but there's like small flies all over the place. You might even be able to see them, and they have a taste for humans. So I'm trying to protect myself, even though we have mosquito repellent stuff on. It's just such an absolutely beautiful composition. My only struggle is the shutter speed, because I can't really find out, or I can't determine on back here on the screen if I'm going to use a shutter speed of 0.3, 0.4 or 0.5. Of course 0.5 gives a bit more silk-like softness to the water, while 0.3 or even 1/4 of a second gives a bit more texture, but it's very, very hard for me to see right now. So I'm just trying a few different things. So the thing is, I'm struggling a bit with the depth of field also, because right now, of course I want as big a depth of field as possible, but I also want as sharp as shot as possible. And I can't get the depth of field I want if I'm shooting at F10 or 11, but I only have my 6-stop filter, or I can just take the filter off and shoot without, but then I will have to shoot at F22 and with an ISO of 50. And shooting at F22, the sharpness will suffer a little bit. If I put on the ND filter, it gets a bit too dark, so I will have to open up the aperture a bit more than I actually want if I want to shoot at ISO 100, so I have to shoot at ISO 200. But at these modern cameras, it's like so-so. It's not really big of a problem. So I've just given up the spot so Sophie can have a go on it. But I have to admit that I was a bit skeptical about going here to the ferry poles, because I haven't really seen that many good pictures from here. I've seen a few. Some are really, really great, but there's a lot of crap in between.
As you probably know, I really love those wide angle shots with a strong foreground leading your eye into the background. To me, an obvious lens choice for a location like this is a wide angle zoom such as a 16-35mm. But you can probably get something cool with a 24-70mm lens too. We explored the area a bit further upstream before we decided to head back down to a few compositions I had spotted on our way up the stream.
So the shoot here at the ferry poles has just been completely beyond my expectations. Just look at the mountain here in the background here. We have the fog coming down from the other mountains, just carving it out, and we have like this perfect triangular mountain, which is just like And then we have all the small compositions. Hello? So we have all the small compositions all along the stream, up through the canyon, I guess it's called, small canyon. And it is just like, oh, I am having goosebumps, and I'm looking so much forward to edit these pictures.
So as we did in the start of the series, I'd like to hear what photo you like the most and why you like that one better than the others. Write down below and remember to read the other comments. You might learn something. Thank you so much for watching yet again. I'd also highly appreciate a like. In the next episode, which will be the last from Great Britain for now, we'll continue up the eastern coast of the Isle of Skye and visit some absolutely epic locations.